On today's show, the Tesla Semi Breaks cover, Tesla surprises us with the next generation Tesla Roadster, and we find out about Faraday Future's future. These stories and more coming up next. This is Ecotricity's Ecotech Roundup show from New Zealand's only carbon zero certified renewable electricity company. We're 100% Kiwi and 50% community owned. Switch today at ecotricity.co.nz. Hi there, I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, a professional musician turned electric vehicle crusader, and I'm here to bring Kiwis a weekly roundup of the biggest news stories around the world in relation to cleaner, greener transport. As always, thanks for joining me. We're starting today's show the only way we can, with the details of Tesla's special event last night, at which it unveiled not one, but two very important vehicles, the Tesla Semi and the next generation Tesla Roadster. Semi first, it's an all-electric, full-size Class 8 day cab Semi with quad electric motors driving the rear wheels, a claimed range of 500 miles, 804 kilometers per charge, with a larger capacity battery pack, 300 miles with the standard pack, and the capability to tow 80,000 pounds. Built with lots in common with Model 3, it has the same door handles and in-cab displays apparently. The Tesla Semi has enhanced autopilot just like the rest of the Tesla family and will be capable of adding 400 miles of range in 30 minutes thanks to Tesla's new mega charger stations, which are of course just designed for the truck, which will be operated worldwide by Tesla and be completely powered by solar electricity harvested on-site and then stored inside power packs at each location. Then there's the cab itself, where the driver, with no engine to worry about beneath the cab, can stand upright with ease and occupies not a traditional position, but a central position in the middle of the vehicle, Formula One style. The Semi will be guaranteed for 1 million miles, says Elon Musk, while payback costs are expected to take 2 years thanks to more than $200,000 in fuel savings. While we don't have a full price yet, Tesla will be taking $5,000 reservations as from today for the Semi, with production promised for 2019. With the Semi out of the way, Tesla's Elon Musk gave everyone an extra surprise by unveiling the next generation Tesla Roadster, the Tesla Roadster 2, by feigning the end of the reveal and then having one drive out the back of the Tesla Semi trailer in a moment of showmanship that I have to give Musk and Tesla kudos for. The 2 plus 2 Roadster 2 will come with an entry-level 0 to 60 miles per hour time of 1.9 seconds, said Musk, a quarter mile time of 8.9 seconds, and reach a top speed of over 250 miles per hour, making it the fastest and quickest production car ever, assuming nobody else beats it to market. Range-wise, it will come as standard with a 200 kilowatt-hour battery pack and have a claimed range of 620 miles per charge. But while it's an amazing spec list, you're going to have to wait to see it, just like the Tesla Semi. And the price? Well, you can get a limited production Founders Edition for $250,000, which you have to put down now, or you can reserve a regular Roadster 2 with a price tag of $200,000 with a $45,000 reservation today. If you want one, you'd better start saving. From Tesla now, we shift to BMW, which, although it's using a massive amount of renewable energy already in its production facilities, has just made a commitment to only use non-fossil fuels to power its factories moving forwards. Announced at the recent United Nations Climate Conference in Bonn, Germany, BMW says it will be buying local clean power for all of its 31 production facilities across 14 countries. It's already buying in renewable energy in large quantities already, but to transition to full renewable, it's looking at using methane gas from a landfill operation in South Carolina, solar panels from local farms, and yes, even power from a South African biomass plant powered by chicken poop and cow dung. With 1 terawatt hours of power to source, it's quite the pledge. So here's to a cleaner carbon footprint for BMW's factories moving forwards. Ever since the Dieselgate debacle of 2015, Volkswagen has been eagerly playing up its intent to become a global leader in electric vehicles. Yet to date, it hasn't really done a whole lot except show a whole lot of different concept cars designed to get us excited about its electric car future. This week, however, it pushed things up a gear, announcing that it would be spending more than $12 billion to bring a whole new line of plug-in vehicles to market by 2025, specifically for the Chinese market. With China now the world's number one auto market, Volkswagen's push will focus on China first, developing 40 new plug-in models over the next few years. It's likely that some of these will be electric and plug-in hybrid versions of existing models, but as with any business venture, the investment in China should trickle down to other markets too. Watch this space. Over the past few months, we've all watched Faraday Future turn from the cocky automotive startup eager to steal Tesla's crown into a shadow of its former self, cancelling plans for its massive $1 billion facility north of Las Vegas, Nevada, and instead focusing on more modest facilities in California. Well, this week, we were treated to the latest twists and turns, with details of an emergency $14 million loan from Innovatum Capital Partners being swiftly followed on Monday by news that Tata, the Indian company that owns Jaguar Land Rover, had purchased a $900 million investment in the company. The deal hasn't been confirmed by either party, so it's still in the rumor stage right now, but if it's true, it could see Faraday Future live to fight another day and maybe, just maybe, come to market after all. Next up, it's time for a quick reminder about Ecotricity's eco-wholesale energy product that could be saving you up to $400 a year on your home electricity bill or $4,000 on your business electricity bill. It works by linking you directly to 100% renewable wholesale prices after paying a small admin fee, and it's the most affordable carbon zero certified electricity that Kiwis can buy. So make sure you sign up and start saving those pennies today by following the link below. We might all be focusing on the Tesla Semi this week, but Tesla's biggest competitor in the zero-emission truck segment, Nikola Motors, which already has contracts drawn up with some pretty big haulage firms, has announced that it's chosen NEL as the sole supplier for its hydrogen fuel filling network. The network, the world's largest at 2,000 miles and 16 stations, will not only keep Nikola truck drivers fueled, but will also be responsible for electrolyzing all of the water required to produce all of the hydrogen fuel those trucks will need. You see, unlike other hydrogen filling networks, which generally get their hydrogen from reforming natural gas, Nikola says it will be producing all of the hydrogen its vehicles need in a clean, green, renewable way to be truly zero emission. And that's from electrolyzing water. I don't have the time here to go into details, but with the trucks expected to exceed 1,200 miles per fill, 1,900 kilometers, Tesla's competition is pretty tough in this segment. It's going to be interesting to see who wins. I've already covered the details of several automakers looking to expand their electric vehicle lineups this week, but I'm going to squeeze one more in before I finish. Renault-Nissan, which is apparently readying itself for a high-volume push. Now that's according to the Alliance chairman Carlos Ghosn, who told Automotive News that the 12 new plug-in models that we're about to see from the Renault-Nissan Alliance in the next 5 years will be high-volume models, not niche market vehicles as they have been thus far. Moreover, these vehicles will occupy prominent positions within their respective companies' lineups. It's frustrating to not know any more details at this stage, but it does appear that Renault-Nissan, rather than lag behind as some have feared, is ready to push a little harder into the electric vehicle segment. Given how disappointed some are with the new range of the new Leaf, I think it's about time. And finally, if you're interested in flying cars, you'll know about the Terrafugia, the company that's been wanting to bring its transition flying car and TFX autonomous flying cars to market for some time. While we've seen working prototypes from the company, nothing is in production yet, but this week, the company was successfully acquired by Geely, the Chinese firm that also owns Volvo and the London Taxi Company. With more cash on board than ever before, things are looking up and, says Terrafugia, we should see it debut its first production flying car in 2019. Which means 2019 is going to be one heck of a year if all of those promised vehicles I've told you about today make it to production by then. Don't you agree? And with exciting thoughts to go, it's time for me to bring another episode to a close. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell your friends about the show. And if you've got some feedback, send it our way. As always, I'll be back soon with more EcoTech goodness, although I'll be taking a small break next week for American Thanksgiving. So make sure you hit that notification bell to find out the minute a new show is uploaded. In the meantime, enjoy your weekend, make sure you do something fun, and don't forget to help keep those wind turbines spinning by switching to New Zealand's only carbon zero certified renewable electricity company. Thanks for joining me. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. Ka kite. See you next time.